concentration that could stimulate the cell multiplication. Another experiment were carried out by Gábor Somlyai. In that experiment, we use another cell line, A4, and here we can see when the cells were transformed from normal water to deuterium depleted water, I mean media. In the deuterium depleted media, the cell grows stopped for a while, and after 15 hours, the cell grows started again. Another experiment with HT29, this is a colon tumor cell line. We also could see the dose effect. This is a normal deuterium concentration, and the lower was the concentration, the bigger was the inhibitory effect on cell growth. Then we went to the United States and asked the Oncotech Incorporation, which is testing several compounds for big pharma, whether it has any anti-proliferative effect. They tested three different cell lines, PC3, prostate, breast, and melanoma cell lines. And they also could prove that the deuterium depletion inhibited the cell growth of the cell growth. All these in vitro experiments, we reduced the deuterium concentration in one step. Later we asked them we asked the scientists to reduce not in one step the deuterium, but in five steps. And the next figure shows that when it was reduced twice within 24 hours, three times, four times, five times within 48 hours, or five times within 72 hours, more times the deep concentration was decreased, the bigger was the inhibitory effect. It is with one cell line, and with the other cell line, we could see the same effect. So that could be something similar what we can experience when people or animals consuming deuterium depleted water, so that there is a gradual decrease in deuterium concentration. We tested a not tumorous cell line, which was a human myometrial cell line. Here we also could see some effect, but it never was so big than comparing to the tumorous cell lines. In the very, very first animal experiment, we used a breast cancer tumor. We transplanted to mice. At the beginning of the experiment, we had 17 mice in the treated group and 11 in the control group. And 87 days later, in the treated group, which were consuming deuterium depleted water, we had 11 mice without any tumor. Here, all the animals has perished except one, which also still has a tumor. In that case, the treatment started right after the day that the tumor had been transplanted into the mice. In another experiment, we used 22 mice in the control group, 22 mice in the treated group, and the prostate cancer was transplanted into the mice. In the first 32 days, both groups consumed normal water. At that time, the average tumor size was the same in the two groups. At that time, we changed the normal water for deuterium depleted water, and you could see that in the control group, the tumor growth was very, very intensive, but it was slowed down and it was much smaller, the growth rate in the treated group. At other experiments, we used again the PCC prostate cancer. The tumor was transplanted. In the first 18 days, both groups consumed normal water. Then the treated group consumed deuterium depleted water for 12 days. After that, we cured the animals and we checked the cells being in mitosis and mitosis in the two groups. We found that 3.6% were in mitosis and only one in the in apoptosis in the control group. And the average tumor size was 3.7 cubic centimeter. In the other group, that ratio was just the opposite. So the deuterium depletion triggered apoptosis, and the tumor value was very much smaller, and the shape was a bowl shape. Here, suggesting that somehow the deuterium depletion can trigger the apoptosis. Gábor Somlyai made another experiment in vitro with that similar system. This is an interleukin-dependent cell lines, which means when we withdraw the interleukin, that triggered the apoptosis. And here we checked that process in normal water and deuterium-depleted water, and the figure shows that somehow the deuterium depletion even triggered the apoptosis, suggesting again that somehow this deuterium could be very important for the cell. The question is how can we explain our results? If we go back a couple of decades, we can say that it is widely accepted that before the cells start to multiply, there is the activation of sodium hydrogen transport system, which causes a pH shift, and that shift somehow a message for the cell to multiply. There's a paper published in the Nature article said that they isolated the hydrogen ATPase gene from yeast, and they used that gene to transform animal cell line, and they could prove that the cell expressed the gene and the ATPase was sitting in the membrane and throwing out the hydrogen, and they proved that the pH shift has occurred. But everybody was surprised that that tumor showed tumorous phenotype in vitro. So nobody could explain how is it possible that the ATPase gene behaves as an oncogene. The real answer we can get if we can suppose that the life can make difference between the hydrogen and the deuterium. And we check for discrimination of isotopes, we can find several papers saying that the lives can make difference between the two hydrogen isotopes. For example, the large hydrogen isotope fractionation between the lipids and gross water between the observing most organisms, or hydrogen isotope discrimination in higher plants, depending on what biochemical way is used to fix the carbon dioxide, or deuterium discrimination between a phosphor hydrogen, phosphor deuterium exchange of phosphorus acid. So it is clear for today that the life is so sophisticated that can differentiate between the hydrogen and deuterium. But it can be very important for us. There is a paper which says that the hydrogen ATPase do not accept deuterium as a substrate. So it means that these enzymes are so sophisticated